Hello students, welcome back to my channel. Today we are discuss about the next part of WTO, SPS and TBT. So this is the contents which we are going to discuss in this presentation. How the WTO resolve trade disputes, what are the technical barriers to trade, and how to distinguish between SPS and TBT. World Trade Organization, that comprises the two things: agreement on the application of sanitary and phytosanitary measures, that is SPS agreement, and it also gives the agreement on technical barriers to trade, that is TBT agreement. So these two agreement which are comes under the category of World Trade Organization, so WTO deals with this. In this, the TBT agreement refers to the technical regulations and conformity assessment procedures and applies to all commodities, not just for food only. So first of all, how the WTO resolves the trade dispute. TBT, I just already told you that the TBT is technical barrier to trade, and in this first consultation is taken, then dispute settlement bodies, the DSB established the panel, and this panel will examine by conduct the meetings with the parties or by meeting with the third parties. Then this panel submit the report to the parties, and then panel circulates the report to DSB, that is dispute settlement body. Then this report goes to the DSB, adopts panel report or appellate review, and DSB adopt appellate review report, and DSB adopt a panel report. Then it goes to the DSB, monitors the implementations of the adopted panel and appellate body recommendations. Then DSB authorize the realization pending full implementation. Special considerations when the developing and least developed countries are involved. So this is the procedure how the WTO resolves the trade disputes. TBT. A TBT is an agreement to ensure that the technical regulations and standards, including packaging, marketing, labeling, etc., not covered under SPS, do not create unnecessary obstacle in international trade. So it means, it is clear here that packaging and marking and labeling, these are not comes under the category of TBT. So TBT agreement and the technical regulations of other countries may be acceptable provided they fulfill objectives of their own regulations. International standards, wherever exist, shall be benchmark for these regulations. All local government bodies and non-government bodies shall also abide by these regulations. Code of good practice shall be complied with, and other regulations are similar to SPS measure. So these are the agreement also recognized by the countries, and rights to adopt the standards they consider appropriate for the protecting human as well as animal and plant life and health, for the protection of the environment, or to meet other consumer interest. For example, national regulations requiring motor vehicles to be equipped with the seat belts to minimize the injury in the event of an accident, or that sockets be manufactured in a manner to prevent the user from electric shocks, fall under the first category. So a common example of regulations whose objective is to protect human health is the labeling of cigarette, indicating that they are harmful to the health. So these are the some preventive measures which are given by the regulations. So it will be help to prevent the accident, help to prevent the health hazards, Most of the regulations falling under the TBT agreement aim to protect the consumer through the information mainly in the form of labeling requirements and to promote fair trade practices. And other regulations include the classification and definition and essential composition and quality factors. So any restriction on trade which is not supported by the scientific justification shall be viewed as technical barrier to trade, TBT. So it should it's clear that the scientific justification should be there. If it is not supported by scientific justification, it means it is viewed as a TBT, technical barrier to trade. And next one is exporting country may ask for scientific data justification for such restrictions. They may approach the dispute settlement bodies, DSB, for resolving the dispute. I already told you how to resolve the dispute of TBT. TBT and SPS, both are distinguished from each other. So what are the differences and similarities in both? We'll see. SPS relates to protect human or animal health from foodborne risk, human health from animal or plant carried risk, animal and plants from pest and disease. And TBT covers the technical regulations and standards and procedures not covered under SPS. So this is the difference between SPS, because this is sanitary and phytosanitary regulation which protects the human from the foodborne hazards, plant carried risk and pest and disease, these all for the animals also. And TBT covers the technical regulations like the standards and procedures that not covered under the sanitary and phytosanitary regulation or agreement. Example, labeling, nutrition claim and quality standard packaging regulations, it will be covered under the TBT agreement. While microbiological contamination, label of pesticides, veterinary drugs, food additives, it will be covered under the SPS agreement. How to distinguish between the SPS and TBT? SPS, it will go for the it will work for the food additives, it will work for the contaminants, it will work for the pesticide residues, labeling related to the safety, plant quarantine and pest disease procedure related to prevention control of pest diseases, while TBT deals with the labeling of the foods or beverages. It will deal with the quality requirement, packaging not involving in SPS, that will also consider in TBT, safety regulations for the toys, covers, subsidies, child labor, tariff, these all comes under the category of TBT agreement. So SPS agreement covers all relevant law, industries, regulations, testing, inspections, certifications and approval procedures and packaging and labeling requirement directly related to the food safety. The TBT agreement refers to the technical regulations and conformity assessment procedures and applies to all commodity, not just for food. This is the example in which the bottling method, it will comes under the SPS agreement. Hygiene practices and packaging material direct contact with the food also comes the SPS, and contaminants will also Codex General Standard for the contaminants, it will comes under the SPS agreement. Additives, I already told you, it's come under the SPS agreement. Then the product description, it will comes the TBT. Labeling will becomes the TBT, and package specifications will come in the agreement of TBT only. So these are the some suggested reading where you can go to these sites and search for the related and more information regarding this topic. Don't forget to subscribe my channel, and thank you so much. Have a good day.